Welcome to Retro Arcade Reviews. My name is John, and in this episode, we will be reviewing the arcade classic Saturday Night Slam Masters, also known as Muscle Bomber, The Body Explosion in Japan. Saturday Night Slam Masters is a wrestling game that was developed by Capcom in 1993. Now, I'm a big wrestling fan since the first WrestleMania. I followed WCW all the way back when it was NWA, loved ECW, Monday Night Wars, Attitude Era, Big Paul Heyman guy, etc., etc. So naturally, I gravitated towards wrestling games like Pro Wrestling and WrestleFest. I remember playing this game and not being immediately impressed. I mean, it felt less like a wrestling game and more like a side-scrolling fight game, kind of like the boards in Final Fight and Streets of Rage where you're fighting in a ring, just slightly more tailored to be more of a wrestling game. So I lost to the first opponent and kind of walked away from the game. I played it once or twice more, but that's pretty much it. It was kind of hard to play anything else during the whole 2D fight revolution. But when I started replaying this game for this review, I found myself playing the game over and over again, even throughout the night. The thing is that once you get familiar with the moves, it is kind of addicting in its own unique way. In this game, you have an option of choosing 8 different hard-hitting CWA wrestlers, including Hagar from Final Fight. If you're playing Team Battle Royale, you have an option of choosing the 2 boss characters from the single match mode. You have to fight the entire roster of wrestlers to obtain the championship belt. Each wrestler has a special attack and a finisher. As with every wrestling game, you have 2 ways of winning. You can either pin them for the 3 count or keep your opponent out of the ring for 20 seconds. Since the game takes place in the Street Fighter / Final Fight universe, Capcom does a ton of cross-promotion with their games and animes, with character cameos and mentions to integrate the characters into the Street Fighter canon. So you may see a character here and there, a mention, or character similarities when playing either this game, Street Fighter, and Final Fight. One popular fact often repeated and cited in numerous sources is that, according to the original Japanese plot, the games are set before Final Fight and depict Hagar's professional wrestling career prior to being elected mayor. In contrast, the world and US version of the series has the game takes place after the events in Final Fight. Now, all the wrestlers somehow or in some way resemble existing ones, and if you go to 10 different review sites, you'll get 10 different types of interpretations. Pro wrestling has a certain look, a certain aesthetic. So in my opinion, it's hard to say that this person represents that person represents this person, etc., etc. Slam Masters just takes advantage of these tropes. But there are 2 that are pretty painfully obvious. One, there's no mistaking that Alexander the Greater was totally inspired by Big Van Vader. Big Van Vader was pretty popular over on the Japan wrestling circuits at the time, as evident in his likenesses appearing in the character Raiden from Fatal Fury and Piroshki from Dragon Ball Z. 2, some sources state that Oni was based on a Great Muta, probably because of the whole blowing mist thing. However, Oni was clearly inspired by the Great Kabuki, who, like Oni, also donned a horned kabuki mask and was the first to use the quote-unquote Asian mist. Fun fact, one of my favorite anime artists of all time, Tetsuo Ohara, best known for his work on Fist of the North Star, worked on the art of the Super NES and Genesis port of the game, as well as doing the promo art for the arcade version, which is a good choice because a lot of his characters kind of look like pro wrestlers anyway. Saturday Night Slam Masters was ported over to the SNES, Sega Genesis, and the FM Towns Marty. The game was followed by an updated version titled Muscle Bomber Duo Ultimate Team Battle in 1993 and a sequel called Ring of Destruction Slam Masters 2 in 1994. Playing the game recently, I look back in retrospect and actually regret not playing this game more because it's a pretty fun game to play through. Although Capcom tried to expand on the fight market by cornering wrestling games, it just didn't fall through. Even when they tried to rinse and repeat the same winning formula from Street Fighter, like having 8 unique fighters from around the world participating in one tournament / championship, great soundtrack, and easy to execute moves, it never reached the popularity of Street Fighter 2, despite the push from the Capcom fight canon. As mentioned earlier, in the 90s, the 2D fight genre was just too loud and did a good job of overshadowing great games released around the same period, even by the same company. But the game is pretty fun and it does manage to hook you in if you give it a fair shot. So I say, tape up your fist, play this game, and let me know what you think.